Hey, this is Stefan from ProjectLifeMastery.com, and in this video, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies and my overall investment strategy around it and whether or not I feel that you should buy Bitcoin or Ethereum or the different cryptos out there. I've been getting a lot of questions about this and people asking whether or not I'm investing in cryptocurrencies and my mindset, my approach around it. So I thought I'd do a video on this and kind of address it for you guys and share with you a little bit about what I'm doing. And then if you want to take on that approach, then fantastic. If you don't know what Bitcoin is, I'm sure you've heard about it by now, but it's a digital currency that's been very popular now for the last few years. Recently has exploded this year in 2017 in a huge way. You know, it's very volatile right now because there's a lot of uncertainty around Bitcoin, other cryptos, and it's not regulated yet by the governments, and they haven't gotten that involved yet too. And so it is a very risky investment. And one thing I'll mention, if you want to learn more about cryptocurrency and Bitcoin, I highly recommend you watch the documentary called Banking on Bitcoin. This is a documentary that is on Netflix. And I'll try to find it on a website and link to it, and maybe there's a stream out there for you guys. But highly recommend it because it'll share with you a little bit more about what it is and help you understand it, the advantages of it, some of the risks of it associated with it. So if you're brand new or if you're more experienced, I do recommend this documentary. Now, for me personally, the way that I look at Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, is that it's very risky and it's very volatile. And many of you guys know that the investments that I make are ones that are more conservative. I've shared, before on my channel, my content, my investment portfolio, and I share my goals and what I invest in typically. So it is very risky investment, and I typically try to avoid having the majority of my portfolio in anything like that. But I do feel there's a place in someone's investment strategy or portfolio for more risky investments that have a potential for a very high return or reward. And so I personally have been investing in Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. And the money that I put into it, it's not like I'm putting everything I've got into it. It's an amount of money that I can afford to lose. And I think that's the approach that I take with it. If you are going to invest in cryptocurrencies, put in the whatever amount of money that you decide to invest, ask yourself, am I comfortable losing this money? Is this money that I can live without? So I would never recommend someone to take their life savings, their retirement money, something that could jeopardize their family, their livelihood, and take that money and put it into something that's that risky or that volatile. Because even though it has potential to become huge and massive, there's also a lot of risk to it where it could crash and it could fail and you could lose all your money. The way that I approach it, I kind of consider it to be my Vegas money. That's kind of what I call it. It's money that if I gamble it and I lose it, I'm okay with that. I'm not going to lose sleep over that. It's not going to affect my livelihood in any way. However, if I win, there's always a chance if you gamble something, there's a high reward. The higher the risk, the higher the reward typically. If it ends up being a large significant amount of money and it wins, then that's something that I want to have a piece of. I want to be a part of it. And I think a lot of people, the reason why I think that you should buy and have some amount, whether it's $100 or $1,000 or $10,000, whatever your threshold is, the reason is because there is a big potential if this Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies becomes something of the future. If, for example, Amazon and Uber and Alibaba start using Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, that's going to be huge. And then eventually, who knows in the future, if cryptocurrencies become the norm and everybody are using it to buy things online, then that's something that has such a high potential return or reward that you don't want to miss out on that. Right now, we could be in the phase of one of the greatest opportunities you could ever have to create an abundance of wealth for your life. So even if you buy $100 and you leave it, and I believe again in the long-term approach, I'm not really that into day trading and doing that sort of thing, but you buy a certain amount and maybe you buy every few weeks, or you can set up repeat buys, and I'll talk a little bit logistics about how to buy and whatnot. But if you do that, then you're taking advantage of what is called dollar cost averaging. So there's gonna be times where you might buy where it's high, you might buy when it's low. I'm not that big in trying to time the market or anything like that, although I do check the markets every day. If there is opportunities when it does crash or there's a correction, I want to be able to take advantage of that. But for the most part, the investment approach that I have is always long term. If you invest $1,000, $100, maybe there's potential over 10 years from now that eventually turns into $10,000, $100,000, maybe even $1 million. You never know. And you know, people that bought Bitcoin back in 2013, I mean, some of what they bought is worth, it's like the return on it is like over 1,000%. It's amazing the return that they got, and there's that potential that you can take advantage of. So what I personally do is, like I said, I buy Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. Those are the three main ones. There's other cryptocurrencies out there, but those are the three main ones. Again, it's money that I can afford to lose. I set up repeat buys, and I do check the market and sometimes manually buy, but I do buy. You know, recently it's been a lot of volatility. China, you know, affected the crypto market recently, so I saw that as a good opportunity to buy. And I'm not looking to you know, get an immediate return on that. I'm not looking to sell it anytime soon. I'm holding on to it for the future. I'm holding on to it for 10 years, even 20 years, who knows, right? And banking on the fact that this could potentially become, you know, a huge win and really, you know, accelerate wealth in a big way. Now, there might be a point where I might sell and take out my original investment. So if I invested $10,000 in Bitcoin, for example, and it goes up to $50,000, let's say, then I might sell, take back that $10,000. So at least my original investment, I haven't lost any money on that. And now the money that continues to grow from here on out is money that's only been made from that $10,000 investment. Okay, so that's kind of my approach and how I think about it as well. How do you buy cryptocurrency? What I personally use is, so you need a wallet, an online wallet. I use Coinbase, which is free to set up. I can link to that as well for you guys. But Coinbase is one of the more popular ones, one of the more secure digital wallets out there. It allows you, it's like a web-based platform where you can buy Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin. You can also sell it as well. When you set up Coinbase, there's quite an extensive verification process where you've got to send them proof of who you are and verify a few things. One of the frustrating parts of it can be that they can restrict your account based on how much you can buy and sell. So for me, I've been doing this now for a few months. I got into a little bit late, but I think it's still very, very early right now. Like, this is not late at all, in my opinion. But for me, I think they limited my account to like $100 a week. So that's all that I could do. And then I think once I had bought a certain amount, or I think once I maybe waited 30 days, then they increased my limits to $1,000, etc. So Coinbase is great. Again, one of the most secure ones. There's other ones out there too. Might be based on your country. I'm not totally sure about that, but Coinbase is one of the more popular ones. I like to buy Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin. Right now, Bitcoin is trading at a high amount, whereas a lot of people, they do like Ethereum and Litecoin because it's more relatively new and it's at a cheaper price point typically. One thing I'll mention too is that, you know, if Bitcoin is trading at $4,000, you don't have to buy one whole coin. The great thing about this is that you can actually buy portions of a Bitcoin. So don't think you have to spend $4,000 in order to buy one Bitcoin. You can buy, 10% of a Bitcoin. You know, you can buy 5%, you can buy 1%. And I believe in having something invested, even if it's $50, you know, $50, just put it in there. Again, consider that money lost. You know, hope and pray that it's going to turn into something. But, you know, put it again, a certain amount, even if you don't have much money at all, I would still buy and put a little bit, whatever I can afford, you know, instead of going to buy clothes or buying the next PlayStation game or going to the movies or going for dinner, take that money, consider it lost, put it into some crypto. And, you know, if it turns into something, then you guys can thank me for that, for this video, for inspiring you hopefully to do that. So digital wallets, Coinbase, that's what I like. If you have a significant amount of money in crypto, then I recommend getting a hard wallet. okay, a hard wallet, something like this. This is the Trezor, and it's a hardware wallet. It's like a USB-based wallet where I can store my Bitcoin and everything on this. I bought this online. It's from, you know, ships from Europe. It is a little bit expensive, and that's why I only really recommend it if you have a significant amount of money, you know, investing in cryptocurrencies and whatnot. But the reason why a hard wallet is useful is that it's an extra layer of protection where no one can really, you know, hack your and take your cryptocurrency or anything like that, because there is some little bit of risk of that, although I haven't really heard of anyone having that at issue with. But hard wallets is just an extra protocol, an extra measure, so that you can actually store your crypto here as well. So I'll link to this as well. Again, it is a bit expensive. It came from Europe. I think I had to pay in euros for it, but there's other ones too. I think this is just one of the best ones out there that I was able to find. But yeah, that's what I got to say about it, guys. I think that it could be a little bit exciting. The potential, the opportunity of it. You know, I follow a lot of what's been going on right now, and I always see my social media and whatnot, the different changes and everything that's occurring from it. Like I said, guys, as long as you go into it knowing what to expect, you're not going into it expecting a secure investment, or you're not expecting necessarily to get that money back, but understand going into it, it's risky, it's volatile. There's huge potential of it, if it does go big, that you could have a piece of, and it can really be a game changer for you. But at the same time, understand that, you know, it is gonna go up and down. There will be crashes, there will be corrections, there will be, you know, once the governments get involved, changes and things of that effect. Right now, there's some countries and people that are even manipulating the market and creating uncertainty, and so it goes up and down. So that's why, again, I try to take the long-term approach and not get caught up in the short-term things that occur and the things that you see. But you know, as long as you're smart about it and you understand those risks and you put aside the amount of money that you can afford to lose, then I think it could be a worthwhile thing. So that's my approach. That's what I'm personally doing. That's my investment strategy. I'm by no means an expert on it. I'm just someone that you know, has done my research and learned what I can, but that's the approach that I take. I've got a lot of friends and entrepreneurs also that are heavily invested in getting into it as well. So there's a lot out there that you could research and learn more about if you'd like. And that's what I always encourage you guys to do, is not to take what I say, but for you to question things yourself and do your own due diligence and take your own path and make sure that you know and understand what it is that you're investing in and where you're putting your money. And again, I think that documentary Banking on Bitcoin is a great start. Watch that. And then there's a lot of other resources out there that you can find online. All right, guys. Well, thanks for watching this video. Hopefully this advice and this information was helpful for you. I look forward to talking again soon. Take care.